Hello, good to see you. So far, we've only programmed very short sequences of actions. But I think we're ready for the next step. Today, our project is going to be a little more complicated. We'll need to pay close attention to each of the sprites' actions and ask ourselves, when did the sprites change their actions, and why did the sprites change their actions? In the conditional loops module, we programmed a sprite to stop at a certain point, like when it touched another sprite or a specific color. But what if we wanted it to start moving again? Let's look at that animation again. When the car stops at the stop sign, what are the important parts of its actions? First, it's moving. The car moves across the stage. Next, it stops. It stops moving when it touches the stop sign. The car stopped moving when the condition of the car touching the stop sign became true. This is a new kind of event. We call these custom events. Events that handle user input, like clicking the green flag, pressing a key, or clicking on a sprite, are built right into Scratch. But if you want something to happen when sprites interact on the stage or touch a specific color, then you need to create a custom event. A custom event occurs when a certain condition becomes true, like when the car stopped at the stop sign. Just like built-in Scratch events, these custom events can stop or start actions in your projects. In Scratch, we use the repeat until block to have actions continue until a condition is true. We put the condition in the until argument, or input, and put actions inside the loop. In computer science, we use something called decomposition by sequence to understand what actions are occurring and how they are related to one another. We decompose, or break down, a sequence of actions and notice the events that start and stop them throughout the program. When I decompose a project using decomposition by sequence, I think about the sequence of actions and the events that trigger those actions to start and stop. Look at this example I made. When I click the green flag, the red marble starts to move. When it touches the green marble, it stops and the green marble starts to move. Can you identify the events in my project? What about the actions? Let's watch that again. This time I'll play it a little slower. When I clicked the green flag, the red marble moved and the green marble stayed still. The first event is clicking the green flag. This event triggers an action. The red marble moves. The next event is a custom event. It's when the red marble touches the green marble. When the red marble touches the red marble stops moving and the green marble starts to move. By breaking down the actions and events in the project, I was able to decompose the sequence of this animation. Today, we're going to look at a Scratch project together to identify what actions occur, in what order they happen, and what conditions or custom events cause them to start and stop. You'll need to pay very close attention and maybe watch the animation a few times to make sure you don't miss anything. Be sure to pick the video of the strand that your class is using.